So hey guys, you're back on SimCity and I'm your host, IDED. And yes, last time we just basically sorted out finishing off this industrial town. Well, I wouldn't say finishing off, I suppose. It's sort of at the stage where it's kind of self-sufficient, which is a big factor. It's running quite smoothly. It's got everything we need. It's exporting ores and all those other bits and pieces. It's got the upgrade on City Hall here to allow us to actually set tax rates. So that's good, because it means now if we start a new town, which I think will be our plan for this one, it will allow us to set that elsewhere as well. So we've got all the sort of bits and pieces we need for this to sort of run quite smoothly. And the good thing about SimCity is if we move to another town now, this one will stay pretty much exactly as it is, but any resources or anything like that that it's exporting will continuously import to our other towns regardless if we're playing this one or not. So it really does help. But what we're going to do as well is we're going to use this one to sort of fund our other city, to help us build it a little bit quicker than we did for this one. So it speeds up your progress, basically. So what we're going to do is we're going to go out to the region view. Now we've got a few other cities we can look at. So let's have a look. We've got this one over here, Trinity Point. It's got water and wind. It's also got sea line around there as well. And we've got this one over here, which has also got water and wind, and it's got a little seaport down there. So the question is what we want to do, because we've obviously got our industrial town, so we're getting all of our resources exported. So we can make some more sort of factory stuff in this city, which is cool. But we want to go for some high value workers as well, so we can start to sort of get those in these other towns. Now, there is a direct train access to this town. And does the train go through? And it does access that town also on the edge. So what we'll do is I think we're going to go for this one. Now, I'm not sure really what I'm going to do with this one. I'm not sure. I suppose we should really go for like an entertainment town. Maybe that would be the plan. So let's get started. Now, as always, I'm going to put in my my high value roads first. Let's get some of those in there. Now with this one, I'm actually going to put another high value road through the central area here. Actually, before we do that, let's get this right, shall we? Let's deselect, let's rotate our view so we can get it, so we're looking at it properly, try and get this as well laid out as we can. So we want it to sort of go up here through the middle. And about there. What we're going to do is we're also going to have to put some interconnecting roads as well. But for now, as always, we're going to put our low value roads in. Now, we're going to choose to do the arced roads because this will allow us to do it on a curve like that. So we can keep with this shape that's going on. And I know we don't need to, but I don't know. I just like doing that, really. So those are some reasonable sized blocks. And we select that, hover over them, because usually there you go, if you hover over a road, usually it'll give you the lineups for them. So we're gonna, I obviously started moving in the wrong direction with that one. And we'll put another one about there. And carry it on to about there. Okay, now first things first. What we'll do is now we've got this town selected, we're going to select our previous town and then we're going to click on these and we're going to say buy anything we happen to need. Oh no, they don't have sewage treatment, of course, but we'll look to buy these resources from our other town basically, so we can not have to worry about those resources so much with this town. So it's beneficial to do so. Alright, so let's start getting our zoning up. Alright, first things first, make sure we check the map. So where is the wind direction? Wind direction's going that way, so we want our industrial stuff, if we're gonna have any, over here, so we don't end up causing pollution. So our residential area should be over here. We're gonna have train access, so we're gonna need to put a train station around here somewhere. So we're gonna have to cut this road off at some point to have that. So first things first then, let's get some residential in here. So we'll put residential, well, we'll put it all the way up to the edge of the train tracks there. We'll put another residential district in here. and another residential district in here. There we go. And we'll also put some commercial in. Maybe I'm thinking about having commercial in here actually, in this sort of sector. We could have like a nice little shopping district. Maybe that's a good idea. So what we'll have to do is we're going to have to get some more roadway. We'll bring it all the way into the centre and all the way up to there. We've got this little alcove here. And then if we select this one, that'll give us our arced road to put that in. And then we're going to have something in this little sector here. I think all we'll do is we'll put another one like that, so we've got a little bit more space. Okay, and then what we'll do, we need to do a split up really. So tell you what, just to lighten traffic, of course, got to select straight road before we start doing this. And we'll put that connector straight through like that. Now I know it makes these sectors a little bit small, but then what we're going to do is we're going to put commercial in here. And then to raise property value, I'm going to mostly put parks here or here, just to sort of bring up the value of that housing. But let's carry on and put in a road going almost up to our beach line there. And then what we're going to do is down this outside edge, we're going to put in a little bit of industrial. But most of our resources we're going to actually import from our other town, so hopefully freight and stuff like that will come from our other town, and thus we shouldn't need too much industrial here, but we do need it to start the ball rolling with jobs and stuff like that, so people don't have to commute to the other town. Well, at least that's the theory. That's what I'm going with. Okay, so at the moment we aren't obviously producing anything ourselves. Plenty of water around here. I'll tell you what, we'll put water there. Okay, so we need to speed up time, get this all sorted as much as possible. But what I'm going to do for now is I am going to swap. So there you go, you can see resources are coming through. That's our great works, which we will most probably try and achieve later. But let's go back to this town. So now that town started off, we've got it on the go, but we want to build up this town a little bit further, I think. I'm tempted, I really think I should maybe build some of these towers. They're really useful to get employment and stuff like that. What are they whinging about? Resource storage is full. Really? It is full. Have we not? I thought we already got, delivery trucks full. We've already got the maximum amount of delivery trucks. Why are you not exporting? Export, export, and export. Alright, so maybe we need to get this sorted then. So, we've reached our limit on there as well. Maybe I should build another trading depot to get more of this stuff out, because that's a bit odd. Maybe we should look at OmegaCo then. Start our production. Needs crude oil and raw ore. And what we are getting oil and ore from this town. So maybe over here, we should look at doing that. So we've got plenty of money. So what we'll do, let's have a look at that resource map, because I know there's more resources in this area, just in case we need them later. So let's have a look. Yeah, so we've got a big chunk of ore there. And that's our coal mine there, so yeah, and we're getting our coal from this spot here, so we want to build over here. So maybe our OmegaCo should go in this area here. Alright, to make sure there's plenty of transportation though. You don't want to end up in a situation that it's not getting exported quick enough. I'm going to go over here and build like that. And then we'll go back. Then we're going to build our first part of our OmegaCo. Boom, chuck that down there. Let's see. So this is what we're going to do, is we're going to produce loads of crates of basically, just resources for our shops, which is going to be really good. And that's going to get exported to our other town as well, you see. So that's why that's quite important. All right, once again, let's get time sped up. Let's get this place running. And we want to get a train connection as well, but we need to upgrade down here to get that sorted. All right, so they need ore. So let's start doing our deliveries locally, shall we? So let's say use locally. Don't need the coal locally, but we do need the ore locally. So we'll use those both locally for the time being then. And that way we can get delivery straight run into here. And there you go, you'll see it start to fill up pretty damn quick. And there you go, that's that mission done as well. They want us to do a petroleum HQ. We still don't have enough. Extract 9,600. How many are we extracting? We're extracting 4,700 a day, which is still quite a chunk. Ah, power. Always power. See, this is the problem we were looking at last time. So I think maybe it's time to start investing in a different form of power. Let's get this. We'll put it out to there. Prop that there. And we're going to waste a bit of money to get ourselves our solar farm up and going, which will produce even more power. So we're going to have loads of power, which is what we're after. So this won't work straight away, but this is more constant than our wind farm for power, which is very beneficial because it means this, where this keeps on breaking down and so the power fluctuates quite a bit, this will produce like a continuous stream of power, which is where it becomes really beneficial. So there you go, so we've already got 30 megawatts excess now, thanks to our solar power plant, which should be enough to produce our Omega. So produces all of that and it gives us extra jobs, which is really cool. Also, the other benefit of the OmegaCo is we can actually expand on it with these. So we can get these production lines and we can also get all of these, but these require special areas to be built. What I would like to get is the drone assembly line. Drone assembly lines are awesome if you can get them. But I think for now, I don't think we're going to get enough resources to be warranting an expansion. So maybe let's look at expanding this somewhat because it needs to be done. Now I think, can we get away with putting a road down here to extract that? Or does it have to be attached? This is the eternal question. No, don't stop trying to join onto that. Annoying. Turn off guides. Nope, it's still doing it. Can we turn off snapping? Surely we should be able to turn off snapping. I'm sure there is a thing for it as well, but my memory does not serve me, but I can't get it to go where I want it to go. Oh, why must you be such a pain, game? Why must you be such a pain? Well, no, that's not where I clicked either. I clicked there. And we just go straight across. I know the angle's too sharp, but you won't let me go around it. Why, game? Why must you do this to me? Why is it just... Nobody wants it to snap. Alright, I'm going to have to figure that out, aren't I? There is a way to turn snapping off, and I damn well know it. Where is it? Gameplay? And it's not in there. Oh, why? So there's a question for you guys then. If you know how to stop the snapping, because I'm sure you have to just hold down a certain button and it just stops it from doing that. If you can think of what it is, then post in the comments. Let me know. Give your old buddy IDED a hand. And not in that way, day-minded people. Ah, because otherwise I'm never going to be able to get this to work. Can I... How about if I go off like that? Can Can I do that? Yeah, look, so that'll work. Okay, so this road needs to be demolished. Wait until that truck's gone down it. And we need to move this road out a wee bit. And that should give us enough space to put another one in there. Boom. Because we really want to get as many of these in here as we can. We need another one over here, so we'll look at that line up there. I'm wondering if we can fit this in and have a small road that goes in between. But I don't think it's going to work. Not enough space, is there? Let's compare that size again. So if that would fit there, then our road can go pretty much in line with that pump there. So can we get away with that? We can. Look at that. Boom. Not enough simoleons at the moment. That's fine. We'll get loads of money, and we're producing now more oil per day because we need more oil. Apparently, OmegaCo is so hungry. But look at that. So we're now producing Omega, which is going to be extremely beneficial, and it's also going to upgrade factories locally and stuff like that. So they need workers. Okay, so the next big purchase is going to be one of these, the Omega Towers, now 120k. See, this is where I've gone totally wrong, haven't I? Because I said I was going to use this town to fund my other town, but I'm not. I'm now just using all the money from this town to produce more in this town. But that's fine, that's cool. So now what we're going to do is we're going to have to go back to our other town and carry on, because we need to produce more money. It needs water, well, yes, but that's why we're buying it. Was there not enough water to purchase? Let's quickly have a look. Are we getting our water reserves? Are we getting enough? Oh, they don't have any water. Okay. I didn't realize they didn't have enough to sell. That's fine. Okay, so let's sort out our water problem. That costs 6,000. This costs 3,500. We're only getting 234 an hour. Alright, let's go back to our other town and produce more water. Ah, all the problems. Keeping your Sims happy has never been so hard. But we can afford to do it here. It's just we need to make sure that we're not getting our water from a polluted area, which is the big issue of this town, because this town's going to be producing a lot of pollution. So there's our water map. Let's have a look. Germ map. See, we're pretty good on that one. Ground pollution. So our ground pollution is there. Those are pretty clean at the moment, but they do have a negative influence, especially Omega, which will be eventually producing a hell of a lot of pollution. Okay, so we can afford to put some more up here. So let's do that. So that can pump out quite a lot. So we've got 31 excess water now, which is more than enough to support our other town. So let's go back. And now, if we click on here, we should be able to click there, click on our water, and there you go. So we're now buying, see, of the 20 gallons available. And this is the other thing, as I was saying, as long as you're in the plus when you leave that city, then on this city there will always be this volume of supply available from that city, which is sort of the way it seems to work, which is beneficial. Always looking at the benefits. So we're buying water, and that's going to go to all these little homes here. Everyone's going to be happy eventually, because we're going to get enough water coming in that way. It's just not a very fast process, but still. What we'll do, so speed up the time, and you'll see, there we go, look at that. Why are you still not? Yeah, I was going to say. Okay, so everyone's happy again, and we're producing a bit more money, so that's fine. Alright, so with that in mind, we could build another little residential district there, but I don't want to do that. I'm going to expand again. So this is where we're going to have to start putting in another major road, because we need to connect these all up. But let's build that out a bit more. We're going to switch to arced road. That's not quite right. Not enough simoleons. How much is that going to cost us? 3,000 by the looks of it. Alright, then we'll wait a minute. We will wait a minute and get some more money before we expand even further. Well, I'll tell you what we can do for now is we can at least put in the start of that residential street. As we wait. No, that's too close. Out there. Yeah, that would be the place to do it. And so as the money keeps rolling in, we should eventually start to get enough. See, look at that, 7,000. Ooh, we're just short. But it's not long, and another hour will pass, and then we'll be able to afford our road. We can box this in, and we can put in the next residential district. It's all of this tedious waiting. And there we go. So get that in there. And get another residential district in here. Now I think in this residential district as well though, we're going to want to put maybe a park in here to sort of spread the wealth. Now we can't afford a park right now, but I think what we're going to do is we're going to push for high level park straight away, so 2,400 for that, so a large fountain park. But we want it a little bit away, really, because we want to have the influence spread from it to our other areas. So maybe here would be where we'll put it. Yeah. And then do is we'll do that, creating more high wealth areas. That makes these people a little bit happier, a little bit more wealth, and that gives us better money. So what we should also do is we're going to have to look at our financials, because we want to correct these. So you always want to put these up to about 12. These up to 11. And these up to 10. So we're getting the highest volume of money we can possibly get without making our Sims unhappy. Ah, so now this is where we're gonna have our other issues, the sewage problem. Now I hate doing this because it's a terrible way to do things, but we're gonna just dump our pollution straight into the ocean. Like the terrible, terrible people we are. But that's because we're going to get an academy. And that's why we're starting to build up our high sort of wealth population here. Because once we've got a good high wealth population, we can build an academy here. So we'll have a mega corp in the other one. We'll have our academy in this one. And then we'll start to have benefits of both, you see. So that's where the real factor is going to come into it. And by having both, that then improves our mega towers, which we can get. Because we can then get drones for our mega towers, as well as getting like the waste reduction levels and like solar crowns and stuff like that to provide extra power, bits and pieces like that. It's all really nice and beneficial. Okay, so let's go back to here. So yes, of course, they want hospital treatment. Now, obviously, we always want a hospital to be on a main road. So what do we need for this? We need 20K. All right, let's see if our other town can spare some money. Needs crude oil, really, already? OmegaCo, have you already gone through all of that, have we? I haven't burnt through all of it yet. Don't know what they're whinging about. And we're producing loads of oil. Yeah, so we've got another one there. We've already got the maximum delivery trucks, yes. We're producing as much oil as is physically possible. Yeah, we are. We're producing enough. Most people could do with another trading depot, I think. But anyway, let's focus on the real facts that are at hand here. Let's get some money in so we can just afford to ship some money across to our other town to help them be more wealthy. Really? Oh yeah, of course, because OmegaCo, we're going to have additional sewage. I don't want to keep on building sewage lines down here, it's not good. We could build it up here. Not really a nice place to build it as well though. But then again, I suppose it shouldn't affect our transmitters, our solar receivers. Yes, I know you've all got high. Oh, you see this one's low, so realistically you're whinging about it, but it's the overflow's there. You've got more than enough overflow. We've even got excess available, so I don't know what my guys are whinging about. In fact, they've got plenty there. We're producing plenty of Omega. Yeah. Definitely, we're doing well. I think this is going to go well. This is our industrial town should be really good. What are you whinging about? Oh look, if you want another car lot, look, there you go. All right, anyway, so we've got enough money now that we can afford to. I'll tell you what as well, we should do that as well. Yeah, Trinity Point doesn't have anything else to sell. But we can send them a gift, and we will send them a gift of 30k, and then all we've got to do is wait a minute and that will depart our town. And then we can jump into our other city and then wait another minute. And it will be there. We'll have money. So we'll just speed this up. Maybe we should have the healthcare around here. Nah, I don't know. Maybe there, actually. It's in the central area. Be quick to get to everywhere. But then these outside. I don't know. Maybe here. There's the money's come through. We'll chuck it down there. Okay, so we've done that, so we've got healthcare already. Okay, so I think that's as far as we're going to get for this episode, unfortunately, because we've run out of time. But we've got our next city on the go. As you can see, we're already starting to build it up, and this is going to be our high wealth town. We're mostly going to put in some entertainment stuff as well, because there's loads of really cool entertainment things we can put in here. We can put in a gambling area as well, but then we'd have to have extra crime and stuff protection. We could put in some cultural elements as well. I'm not 100% sure. I'm not sure what I'm going to go with. But I suppose you'll have to wait and find out next time. So thanks very much for joining me. This is IDED, of course, signing off for another great episode of SimCity. And we're going to be playing some more of it as time goes by. So remember to stay tuned. And of course, if you enjoyed it, then click the little thumbs up in the bottom corner for me. Go on, you know you want to. So till next time, this is IDED signing off. And I'll catch up with you again very soon.